basically a few groups, okay, on these four main topics. Okay, so thank you very much for your cooperation. Okay, this is what I got from you all. Okay, the responses that I got from you all. So we are going to have 12 groups, okay? But when I try to distribute, look at the distribution of the topic and also the groups, I don't really like it, okay? Because majority, okay, most of you, most of the groups are actually focusing on the second topic. So I really want some volunteers from the groups in topic two to move to topic four. Okay, at least one or two groups need to move to topic number four. Okay, can I see any volunteers? Can I have any volunteers? Wow, ada siap ayam berkokok lagi. Okay, any volunteer? Because we need more groups for topic number four. Okay, Jin, Junkai, Hazel, Ira, Dini, Iqbal, and also Rafi. Boleh, can I hear your voice?
Ya, Doktor.
Okay, boleh tak siapa-siapa buat topik empat? Any volunteer? Okay, the process of doing the research will be the same for everyone. Maksudnya, there is no something yang very easy, not difficult for everyone. Okay, because the workload will be the same. So it's just that you need to find, to find literature, and then to find later on, you need to, you know, to do some, to prepare chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, just like everybody else, but on different topic. So, but the workload will be the same for everyone. So you don't have to be scared of the topic or whatever. Okay, the most important is for you to learn the process of doing a research. Okay, itu my main purpose actually. Right, so I really need to see some of the groups from topic two move to topic four. So I would like to see, I would like to have volunteers among you all. Can I have like maybe two groups? Okay, maybe you can take one group, go to topic number three, one group to topic number four.
Okay, group Iqbal.
Iqbal? Okay, Iqbal nak buat apa Iqbal?
Move to topic four.
Okay, thank you Iqbal. I really appreciate that.
Okay.
Group Dini.
Kejap, sat. Tadi group Iqbal. Okay, group Iqbal. Okay, tak apa, nanti saya masukkan kat sini, group Iqbal. And then, Dini, topik tiga.
Topik tiga, ya. Okay.
Okay, thank you, Dini.
Okay.
Alright, so, okay. Now, saya rasa lega dan we now can move to the next one, okay. So basically, this is actually some of the social issues for topic number two. Okay, you can, I want you to focus only at a certain scope. You don't have to do all the social issues. This one is for topic number two. Okay, so now we already have, okay, only like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 groups are going to do topic number two. So you can choose either on the job opportunity, criminal activities, safety awareness, perception and expectation of public facilities. It's up to you. You only take one main topic from here, okay? But let's say you want to do something else. What I'm suggested here, you think that is not, you would like to do more, for example, to do something else. It's okay, just let me know, right? As long as it is one of the social issues as the impact of the foreign workers. Okay. Right. Is everybody clear? Okay, faham ke? Can you faham?
Faham, Dr.
Thank you so much. Right, so let's move on to the next one. Right, everybody, each of you, every single group, you need to think about these three principal factors, okay, that attract foreign workers to Malaysia. So preference of the employers, maksudnya most of the employers in Malaysia, they prefer to have the foreign workers. Why? Because of they pay low wages, for example, and then the foreign workers can work more than the local workers because they don't care about, you know, public holidays, their family are not here, so they don't have to go to kenduri, they don't have to attend to a certain invitation and so on. So that's the reason some of the employers, they prefer to have foreign workers rather than local workers. So every all of you need to think about it also, all right? And then also lifestyle and working conditions. Okay, many foreign workers, they prefer to stay in Malaysia. Why? Because they say that the economy is stable, and then even the benefit that they get, you know, even they are just like operators, for example, they can go to the private hospital when they are not feeling well, for example. So, and then they can get whatever they want here. They can get halal KFC, halal McDonald's, for example. Rather, if they go to, you know, the Western country, they work there, they cannot get the halal food, for example, okay? So the lifestyle and also the working condition for them can attract them well, okay? So that's the reason they choose Malaysia as their destination, okay? And also attractive career path, okay? So this one also, if they work hard, they will get promotion, okay? Just like local workers. Some of them now, they can be supervisor, okay, at their workplace. So this is, and then in terms of payment, okay, the salary, they get a very good salary. Okay, maybe to local people, you know, like 1,000, 2,000 ringgit is not much, but to them is a lot, for example, okay? So these are the factors that you need to include in your searching. When you search for literature, when you search of when you want to develop your problem statement later on. Okay. So I really hope that you can think all about all this and get more input, get more information for your topic. Right. All right, so let's go to the next one. Okay, so one thing that we always talk when we want to develop a topic, okay, for a research, for a study, and if we want to start a research, we need to think about research objective, okay? So basically, actually we already discussed this one in our previous lecture. So research that we are, we're going to do is more scientific, okay? It's scientific and it must be systematic. So that's the difference between academic research and other kind of research. So research is an instrument to obtain knowledge, which is valid and reliable. And I just mentioned it, it must be supported by knowledge of scientific knowledge and also logical foundations. Okay, research is also an instrument to collect evidence in order to give an answer to any doubt or problem which arises. Okay, so remember I mentioned also that some people to us, maybe that issue is a problem to us. Okay, that's the reason we want to do a research. But some other people, to some other people, our problem is not their problem, okay? So we cannot judge that, okay? Maksudnya, we cannot judge people's problem as very simple, kita pandang rendah, you know, we feel that they are not doing a good research and so on. it is depend on your topic and also the priority of that person, right? So a research is also an instrument to correct any stereotyping, traditions and beliefs which are untrue, okay? So for example, we think that, you know, some superstitions among Malaysians, okay, is not good for the new generation, okay, the young generations. So you make a research that, for example, that superstitions is no longer valid in these modern days, okay? So that one also can be a research, okay? It's also used to predict the existence of a phenomena. For example, the most important phenomena that we are going through now is COVID-19, okay? So we want to know exactly what the COVID-19 is, the effect, and how long, okay? How long it will affect the economy of the world, for example. So we use a research in order to predict the future. Okay. A research also an instrument to explain the truth about a phenomena, such as its similarities, differences, and also relationships. Okay. So you use a research as a way, a method for you to explain things, okay, to people. Okay. For example, we have so many similarities in terms of, you know, like economic problems among countries in the world, especially the developing countries like Malaysia, okay? So maybe we can see the similarities among Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, you know, and also Singapore, and what are the differences that we have, what kind of relationship, the variable, you know, maybe the more people in a certain country, the economy will be less growth, okay? For example, so that one is a thing that you can do in a research, okay? And then a research is conducted to find answers about something that is unsure of, okay? If you already know things well, why should you do a research? You don't have to, okay? So a research, we only do it when we want to get an answer, we want to do an experiment, we want to test, then we do a research, okay? So research is conducted using systematic methods. This is very, very important because you need to convince the society, you need to convince the public that what you are going to get, your results, whatever you have, is okay to be generalized for something that you are studying, right? So is to ensure that the information obtained is reasonable and is supported by quantitative or qualitative data, right? So I just want to remind you, later we all also we will talk more about quantitative and qualitative data, even you already learned in your statistics class last semester, okay? And then a systematic research process. Okay, now I want you to start thinking of your topic, that four topics that we are doing for the foreign workers. Okay, so I want you to discuss among your group, okay, what is actually your research problem? Okay, what kind of problem that you want to study? And then you need to determine the research objective. Research objective, what actually you want to solve, okay? What can you get? Okay, actually it is good for you if you can search, okay, using Google, and then you find related articles to your topic, and you see how people, you know, develop their research objective. For time being, I just want you to have one research objective, okay? So you need to discuss among yourself, and then I want you to come up with one objective. What actually you want to, what is the problem? What actually you want to solve in your study? And then reference to literature, you need to find literature, related papers, related thesis, related articles, newspaper, either in from newspaper or from book, okay? That sorry. That related to your study. And then we are going to also learn in this class how to design our research, okay? That one will be the next chapter. And then how to develop your instrumentation. Okay, basically for this class, okay, for your FYP, the majority of the students, they use questionnaire as their instrument. So we are going to learn how to develop a questionnaire. And we are going to also do the data collection. And also we're going to learn a bit on data analysis, but not much. Because data analysis you already learned in your statistics class, right? So we are going to focus more on the other processes, all right? So and then the last one is to get results from your study. Okay. There are actually three ways that we can do a research. Okay, so this one we call it as research paradigms. Okay, so the first one we call it as positivist method, right? So positivist method is actually emphasizes the accuracy of research evidence. Usually for those it is it is used applied by people who use experimental research and survey methods, okay? Or what I can say, if you are doing the quantitative research, then positivist method is one of the best way for you to apply, right? So, and then the next one, interpretative method, okay? So this one is to explain a phenomena by using verbal descriptive data. So analysis of verbal descriptive data is emphasized over numerical analysis, okay? So the first one is actually, we can see, is more on the numerical analysis, okay, quantitative. The second one is for qualitative research, more because you interpret things, okay? And then the last one is critical method to improve the social conditions of mankind, usually use the critical method. So this one is just to understand the relationship between social groups and how social differentiation is created, right? Right. Now let's talk about quantitative and qualitative research. Okay. As I told you before, most of us will do the quantitative research. Okay, not many actually do the qualitative, but somehow quite a number of our supervisors, they are actually qualitative people. When I say qualitative people, they did their PhD using qualitative research, okay? So for myself, for example, I'm a quantitative researcher, okay? So then most of my research will be quantitative research. Okay, I give example for qualitative people. For example, Dr. Siti Zaleha, and then Dr. Nur Halima Idris, Dr. Matsha, and who else? Yeah, qualitative. Law people usually those law. Their field is law. And who else? Dr. Rose Halizawati. And then we have quite a few number. And they are qualitative researcher. So just in case, okay, you are assigned to have these qualitative people, they may suggest you to do qualitative study. But you have the right to... you have the right to choose, actually. Either you want to do quantitative or qualitative. It's up to you. So you kena cakap dengan your supervisor, okay, doctor, I prefer quantitative instead of qualitative. I prefer qualitative instead of quantitative. So you have the right to say, all right? No worries. Okay, what is quantitative research? The term quantity refers to a discrete number, okay? We use numerical. So numerical data, and then we can also check the accuracy of the numerical data. Okay, a research problem is stated in a form of a hypothesis. Okay, you already learned last semester in your statistic class how to test a hypothesis. Okay, usually you can use two tests, you can use ANOVA, and then you can use those tools actually to test your hypothesis. For example, those are actually tools for quantitative data, right? So, and then you can use either descriptive studies or inferential studies. Remember, inferential studies can be done, you can claim that you are using inferential statistics if you are using a sample. If you don't have any sample, it means you cannot do inferential studies. All right, any question? Ada siapa ke nak tanya anything? So please ask. Okay, all right. So I assume everybody understand what I'm trying to say. Okay. Okay, let me see. Okay, I don't share these slides in the e-learning. Okay, so that's the reason I asked you to find the book. Okay, so you people, you know why? Because I want you to learn how to do literature review. I want you to learn how to read a book. Okay, so if you just depend on lecturers, slides and so on, so it means that you won't learn more. You won't be a good researcher, okay? So if you read a book, you know, you understand what every single page is all about. So it means that you are doing a research. You are learning something, okay? So please get the book. As I said, if you need to buy the book, just let me know. I will check the price for you. Otherwise, you can ask your seniors. Your seniors, maybe they want to sell their book to you, right? Right, so let's continue to the next one, okay? So there are two types of studies in quantitative research. The first one is descriptive study, and the other one, we call it as inferential study. So when do we need to do descriptive study? Okay, descriptive study is actually when you are using a population, the whole population in your study. Then you need to use descriptive. But if you have a sample, you also can do descriptive study. But if you don't have a sample in your study, you cannot do inferential study. Inferential study can only be done if you have a sample, right? So you need to understand that. So respondents comprise all the subjects in a population, and you cannot leave even one person from your study. That what population is, okay? So we don't have any such thing as hypothesis when you use descriptive study, right? So significant test is not needed. Why? You don't have any hypothesis, okay? So what can you use for descriptive study? You can use frequency, percentage, mean, mode, median, standard deviation, variance, and also Z-score, okay? Results of the study only apply to the subjects which are being studied. So for example, you are doing a study on UTM students. So whatever results you get is only for UTM students, okay? So results of the study will not be generalized to other groups. So you cannot use the results, you know, for example, to some other students. For example, like UM students, because you only focus on that kind of population, right? And then inferential study, you can use it when you have a sample. What does a sample mean? When you take us, you take a part of your population to be your sample. And the most important, your sample should be randomly selected. So if you are not, if you don't choose your sample randomly, then inferential study also cannot be done, right? So inference tests are used to analyze data, and you can use statistical tools like t-test, chi-square, ANOVA, and so on, okay? Because you have hypothesis and you want to test it, right? So then you can use this kind of tools, okay? The test results derived from the subjects in the sample are generalized to all subjects in the population. If you take the population, a sample from UTM students, so it means that you can generalize whatever results that you get from your sample for UTM, the whole population of UTM, for example. Okay? Understand? Faham ke? Hazel, where are you?
Yes, doctor.
Yeah, who is it? Siapa tu? Okay, saya ada kelas kejap. Okay, so any question? Any question?
Tak ada, Dr.
Hazel? Where are you, Hazel?
No question, Dr.
No question. Anissa? Nur Anissa, where are you?
Saya, Dr.
Ada soalan ke?
Tak ada.
Are you sure tak ada soalan?
Setakat ni lah.
Setakat ni lah, okay. Lutfi, where are you? Lutfi, are you here or not?
I'm home, doctor.
Okay, yes, so yes. Any question?
No.
Tak ada?
Tak ada, doktor.
Tak ada, okay. All right, so let's continue to the next one, all right? What is the differences between descriptive and inferential study? Okay, actually, I already mentioned this one many, many times that inferential when you have sample, right? So hold on, let me see if I can write something that you can understand better. Okay. Okay, people, by the way, for your the topics that we're going to do, so I want you to do I want you to have a sample. For sure, we are not going to use the whole population for our study. Okay, that's for sure. Right. So right, I did mention this one for those who already who took statistics class in me, they already saw this one before. Okay, just imagine this is your population. Okay, this is your population. So what happened? So this is your sample. Sample is a part of your population. So in this case, if you are use population, then you need to use descriptive statistics. Okay, you can do descriptive research. But if you have a sample, so it means you can do inferential study. Okay, so I have a question. Okay, I'm not sure whether my ex-students, okay, they can still, my students before they still can remember this or not. Okay, so for example, let's say Malini, okay? Malini, she's going to use a population, a sample. She has a sample in her study. Okay, and then she sees her supervisor, and then her supervisor said to her, Malini, okay, I want you to use descriptive statistics only. I don't want you to use any inferential statistics. Okay, I want you to use to do descriptive study. Is it okay or not? Can or not? What do you think? Boleh atau tidak? Kahwai?
Yes, doctor.
Sebab ini my A student. So you must know how to answer my question. Right. So what do you think, my dear? Can Malini use descriptive even she has sample in her study? Boleh ke tidak?
Tak boleh. Boleh.
Boleh ke tak boleh ni?
Sample only can use for inferential. Cannot use for descriptive.
Say it again, please. Sorry.
You can use for inferential, but you cannot use for descriptive unless it's everyone.
Okay, that's your opinion, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let us some other people. Nurul Hani. Hani, where are you?
Yes.
Okay, Hani, dulu ambil step dengan siapa?
Dengan Dr. Tan.
Dr. Tan, oh, lagi Taren. Okay, so Hani, what do you think? Boleh tak kawan kita guna buat inferential study? Dia ada sample. Okay, but the supervisor said he or she wants this student to do descriptive study. Even she has a sample in her study. Is it okay or not?
I think it's okay.
Kenapa? Cepat.
Tak tahu, tapi rasa boleh.
Rasa macam boleh, tapi tak tahu kenapa. Okay, Kuhan, my other good student, you should know how to answer this one. Kuhan?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, what do you think?
I think if sample means is can only use for inferential, but cannot use for descriptive.
Sorry, say it again, it's not clear.
I think only can use for inferential, but cannot use for descriptive.
Okay, all right. Now, ask Malini. Malini, where are you?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, Malini, we are talking about you now. So what do you think? Can you use only descriptive? You don't use any inferential in your study, can you?
I think can, but if you use sample, then you have to use inferential statistic.
Okay, so but your supervisor say no. He or she doesn't want the inferential. He only wants you to use descriptive study. Is it okay?
I think okay.
Why?
The population studies to carry on.
Okay. All right. So people, please look here, right? So as I said, your descriptive, okay, population, when you have the whole thing, so you need to use descriptive. You cannot go here. Cannot, right? But if you are here, you have sample, you can use either descriptive and you can use or inferential because sample is a part of population. It is belong to this big circle, right? So therefore, if your supervisor say even you have sample, but your supervisor say he only wants you to do descriptive study, is okay. But the problem is if you have only you have population, but you don't have this part right here. You don't have any sample. So it means you cannot do any inferential. You only, your study is only limited to descriptive study. Understand? Faham tak? Arfan, are you here?
Doktor.
Faham tak Arfan?
Buat faham.
Okay. Alright. So then, what is the difference between descriptive and inferential study? So okay, when you don't have a sample, kalau if let's say you don't have a sample, and then your supervisor asks you to do inferential study, it definitely cannot. Okay, cannot. Why? Because you don't have a sample. Syarat requirement to do an inferential study is for you to have a sample. Okay, Sabah, where are you? Are you here, Sabah?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, do you understand?
Yes, doctor.
You understand what's going on?
Yes.
Okay, so let's say you don't have a sample.
Okay.
In your study, can you use inferential?
No, I have to then definitely do the descriptive.
Yeah, good. All right. Thank you for your answer. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Qualitative research. Okay, qualitative is something totally different than quantitative. Okay, so usually people will use different approach to get their data. Okay, so these methods are more appropriate for investigating individual or group phenomena. They involve emotions. You know why? Because emotion is something very subjective, all right? Motivation, empathy, and so on. You cannot measure your emotion. You cannot measure someone's sensitivity, for example, okay? So maybe actually it's the best for you to use qualitative approach in order to study this kind of issues, all right? So it needs qualitative data, which are collected through interviews. Some psychological people, okay, psychiatrists, they prefer to use observation methods, right? And then triangulation method in qualitative research. This one is a very, very popular applied by qualitative people. So the triangle, okay, the triangle is actually formed this one, okay? So we have time. Sorry. Time, space, and then not so good. My drawing is not good. Okay, so we have this triangle. So it involves time, different space, and then different individual. So that's how you use that approach in order to study your phenomena. Okay, so for example, time, you collect, I give one example. So you want to see the influence of environment towards someone's personality. So you collect the data from that person since small until teenagers, adult, and so on. Okay. So you measure. You not measure. You observe the changes throughout different times. Okay, and then space and also individual. So the triangulation method applied in qualitative research studies the phenomena through multiple site perspective, those three, right? And it ensures the results of a qualitative research will have a high level validity and reliability. Okay, the difference between quanti and quali, okay, qualitative research, usually they really study in depth. Okay, they really study in details, okay, about something, about individual, about a phenomena, and so on. Okay, that's the difference. Sometimes, okay, for quantitative, we need like to take at least 30 people, 30 respondents for our study. But for qualitative people, they only maybe need just two individuals to study, but they really study about these two people, okay? So that's the difference, okay? And then the research procedure. Okay, so I would like you to think, okay, start thinking now. Okay, whatever, when I say you start thinking now, so it must be related to your four main topics, okay, regarding the foreign workers. So I want you start focusing, discussing, you know, what is actually your research problem is, what are your what your research questions are, and then what kind of questions that you want to solve, okay? And then your research objective, research hypothesis. I will guide you more on this part right here, okay? For the research objective and research hypothesis. But for the time being, I would like you to get on this one, okay? And so we'll have every Thursday, so the first hour, so we go to do the lecture, and the second hour will be we will discuss on your assignments, okay, what I have assigned you in the previous week. So for next Thursday, so I want you to you already have this research problem and also research question. So, and also research objective. So you only need to write one research objective, okay? So what is actually a research problem? So you need to write the issue, okay, that attract attention or motivate a researcher. Researcher is you to conduct a study on it, okay? I know this topic is actually given by me. You don't choose it, you, okay? So it just like buat kerana terpaksa. So you don't have, you have to, okay? So it means that what is actually can motivate you, the topic can motivate you to conduct a study. And then before a research is carried out, the research problem should be defined clearly and precisely. So what is actually a research problem? So you need to write a paragraph, okay? A paragraph. So you need to tell me, okay, the interest and experience of the researcher, for example, so intends to further his knowledge in the aspect of interest him. So what are the theory, okay? So people, what I want also, I want you also to use your experience from all your classes that you have taken so far, okay, in UTN. So maybe you have came across a good theory that you can use for this, for your topic. So please do so. Please include that, all right? And a replication of previous research, okay? Or you can, what you can do is actually you can Google and find maybe some other people, they have done the same topic like yours. So you can replicate, you can repeat whatever that person has done, but in different contexts. For example, that person did that one in India, for example, but you do it in Malaysia, okay? So, but the same process, but only the location is different. Okay, that person, let's say, use theory A, but now you want to use theory B. That one also can, right? So I would like to see that one also, okay? It's okay. I mean, it's okay for you to do exactly like other people, but at different location, different respondent, it is allowable. Okay, and then contradictory result of past research. Okay, so research problem, how do we get it? So for example, we don't like the theory that have been developed before. So we want to do our own, the new one also can. Okay, so and then, for example, previous study has showed that the foreign workers has created many chaos, okay, crimes and so on in a country where they are working. So what you can do, you want to show something contradict, also can, right? So for example, your research title, you can do like this one, eh? A comparison of the level of proficiency in English language among officers in the government and private sectors. So you want to do some comparison. And then the research problem, why you want to do this research problem? Okay, what motivate you? Because before this, no information on the levels of English language proficiency among officers in the government and private sectors are available, for example. Okay, so that motivate you to do that research. Okay, so as I said, this is your first assignment where you need to do the research problem. You need to write a paragraph on the research problem. So what should you include? So the research should be practical. It can be investigated and the data which is collected can be analyzed. Okay, that one is very, very important. So if you think that some of the data cannot be obtained, it's very hard to, it's very difficult for you to collect, don't do that topic. Change to some different topic. Okay, it should be important. It should be meaningful investigation. It should give some significance to the knowledge. That one is very, very important. Must take the research target. So what is your target? The population. Okay, so then I want you also to think which part, where do you want to do your research? For example, but I really encourage you, okay, because since I'm doing actually the one in Kulai Johor, foreign workers in Kulai Johor, maybe you can also do that in Kulai. So at least we can discuss in the future on some of the problems and also issues. Okay, if you want to do it in, let's say, Klang, Selangor, also can. If you want to do it in Negeri Sembilan, also can. Right, must state the main variables that will be studied. So the variables, what kind of variables that you want to study. So I want you to list them down. Okay, must be stated clearly to enable readers to understand the issues that are being studied. It must be stated precisely, blah, 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 right? So, and then also inconsistency of statement in research problem. A research problem exists when there is a conflict of statements or inconsistent evidence concerning an issue being studied. So we don't want something good all the time, okay? So sometimes something different, something contrary is actually worth more. So that one can be a very good research, okay? And then if all the statements concerning an issue are consistent, complete and not conflict, so there will be no research. Semua dah cantik. Semua is so beautiful. So why should we do a research? We don't have to, okay? A problem also exists when there are incompatible theories and practices related to an issue. Okay, you also need to mention, okay? Why, for example, the problem exists before regarding these foreign workers. It has been Malaysia issue for a long time. But what is the difference before and now? Okay, for example, to summarize, a research problem occurs when inconsistent or conflicting statement between opinions, past research findings, theories, and practices exist. Okay. Right, so this is how you can start writing your research problem. Okay, step one, express the base statement. This statement is based on the past research finding. So the most important, you need to get some information from the past research, okay, theory, practice, and so on. So you can start writing your research problem. Remember, I said this one, I want you to write in one paragraph. This one for first day next week. Right. And then you need to reveal inconsistent statements. Okay, what are the inconsistent that occurs that make you want to do the research? Okay. And then express speculations based on inconsistent statement. For example, okay, this speculation based on the inconsistent or conflicted statement, and that's the reason it need to be studied, right? Step four, develop the research objective. As I said, only after you have done all this, I will guide you how to write this part right here, okay? Some researchers only refer past research evidence that shows similar findings. Okay, as I said, don't look for people who always have same opinion with you. We want to see something contradict from what you think. That one is going to be a very good research. Okay? Okay, any question? Ada siapa? Ada soalan tak?
Doctor?
Yes.
For the paragraph, we have to write like individually or in a group?
In a group. A group. This one group project, group assignment. Okay.
Yes.
Doctor, how much the word limitation word?
Okay, saya tak boleh nak cakap Latif. Okay, but it's going to be okay. I'll show you. This one. All right, sekejap. Okay, let me share with you. Can you see this one? No? Yes? Boleh nampak tak? Can you see?
No, no, sir.
No, no. Can see, no, sir.
Okay, hold on, yeah. Let me share. Okay, can you see now? Can you?
Okay.
Right. So this is example. Okay, problem statement. Usually in your chapter one, okay, your chapter one is introduction chapter. So what you need to do, first part is background of the study. It's like an introduction to your study. Okay, right. This one, the whole complete report need to be submitted later. But not now. Now we are going to do part by part. And then later you need to combine all your assignments and you need to submit as one complete report. Okay. So this one, okay, problem statement. So saya bukan, I don't expect you to write a very long one. If you can write just like this, all right, it's okay. It's good enough as a start. Right? So for example, it is necessary. Remember tadi dia cakap what are the steps? So you need to based on the previous study. So and then if you get some information from the previous study and then you go to the next step, right? So you need to include why is it important? What is the contradict statement between before and what you want to do now? So that's all, okay? So this is what I want you to do for next Thursday. Just a paragraph like this for your problem statement. Okay, can you understand that? Any question? Ada soalan lagi? Ada apa?
Doctor, what about the plagiarism?
Sorry, sabar?
Doctor, what about the plagiarism? Is there...
About what?
Plagiarism.
Plagiarism. Okay, for time being, is I don't want you to copy and paste. If possible, I want you to write on using your own words. Okay, please, 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 right? Not just copy and paste. If you get some from other articles, you know, you found in let's say in anywhere. So please summarize using your own words, right? So it's not going to be long, just one paragraph like this. I'm sure you can do it. So let's say there are like four people in your group. So one person write two sentences is good enough, for example. Okay? So anybody else?
Ada tanya?
Yeah.
Ada limitation article tak?
Limitation macam mana? Apa maksudnya tu, Nisa?
Maksud untuk problem statement ada limitation artikel yang kiranya boleh lebih daripada 3 ke atau 2 je.
Saya tak ada limit kan untuk masa ini sebab nanti kita akan masuk yang literature review chapter dan baru ni. Untuk yang sekarang ni any tak kira berapa.
Okay, thank you doktor.
Alright, saya juga mengizinkan sekejap ya. Siapa nak tanya? Sekejap ya. Okay, I allow you to write it either in English or Bahasa Malaysia. Okay? Yeah, Dina.
Doktor.
Doktor. Apa ni? Doktor nak buat problem statement dulu eh?
Ya, yeah, hanya problem statement.
Tadi, yang question punya tu nanti eh?
Nanti.
Ke sekali?
Nanti. Masa okay. Hari Khamis kita akan belajar untuk write the research question and also research objective. But you kena fikir. You need to think starting from today, what is your research objective? Only one objective. What actually you want to solve based on your problem statement. Okay? But you can check next Thursday whether what you are doing is correct or not. Okay?
After getting citations,
citation, okay. For time being, even you don't have any citation, not the correct format is okay because we haven't learned that one yet. So we are going to have one chapter just on the literature review later, where you going to learn how to write the correct format for your citation and references. Okay. So for time being, I just close one eye. Okay, it's okay. Even you are, but later you need to, yeah, we are going to learn step by step. Okay, if you want to put a citation, it's okay. If you don't want to put a citation, it's also okay, right?
Okay, doctor.
All right. Okay, anybody else? Nawfal, where are you, Nawfal?
Yes, doctor.
Okay ke tidak?
Okay.
Okay, apa yang okay?
Semua okay.
Semua okay. Alright, so Irvina, are you here, Irvina? So long, dah lama tak dengar, Irvina.
Yes, doctor.
Apa-apa okay?
Okay, good.
Okay, good. Okay. Alright, yang by the way, yang ada group kita ni, group 1, section 1 or section 2?
Section 1.
Section 1. Okay, section 1, if you want to leave the class now, okay, you can, but please, I want you to scan the attendance first. Okay, sekejap ya. Let me open the attendance. Section 1, kan?
Section 2.
Yes.
Sekarang ni tak tahu, mana ke tu? Korang biar betul.
Mana ke tu?
Yang section 1 ke 2?
Section 1.
Section 1 ke 2?
Yes, doctor.
Siapa? Which section actually?
Innovation.
Okay, so alright. Tolong scan dulu you punya attendance in section 2. Can you please stay for a while? Thank you.
Tak ada pun.
Kejarlah, sabar bertenang. Baru nak buka ni, bang. Okay, dah.
Alah, internet. Sekejap, sekejap. UTM Smart tak ada buka pula.
Okay, thank you everyone. Okay, kalau tak, just let me know. How come I have, supposed to have 24 students tapi yang dah scan 27 orang. Biar betul korang ni.
Korang section.
Oh, korang ni, sabar ni section 1. Bertenang, bertenang. Apa ni, kena deactivate dulu. Eh, bahaya betul lah korang.
Unmute translation.
Unmute
translation.
Teruk betul lah.
Siapa, siapa?
Tu siapa
tu? Unmute salah.
Okay, tu saya
jadi. Sorry. Aku nak buat kohan.
Sekejap, session tu.
Fizi pun sama.
Okay.